Hi, and welcome to On Two Wheels. Today I'm going to talk to you about a project that I've been very excited about. I'm building a rally tower for my DRZ 400. In this video, I'll start walking you through the process of the different considerations and how I start building it. Stay tuned. So based on the type of riding that I normally do, I want to turn the DRZ into a more adventure and long distance riding bike. So that means I need a few more accessories and things which will make the ride more comfortable and make it a lot more enjoyable. So I want to add a couple of extra switches, a charge point for a mobile phone, a couple of extra lights, as well as a phone mount and a windshield. So to add all of this, I need a bit of extra space. So for that, I'll be actually building a small dashboard which all of this can fit on. So this is a build project that I actually had in mind for a couple of years, but I never really got onto it with other projects coming in, and this has been sitting on the back burner for a while. So recently I got introduced to Devin. So he also rides a DRZ 400 and he too wants to build a dashboard and a rally kit for his bike. So we put our minds together and bounced ideas off each other and started the project. So the interesting thing is I've never met Devin in person before. It's purely been talking to each other online, and pretty much the design process has happened through Facebook Messenger basically. So this was another interesting twist to the whole project. So essentially we both had a very similar idea on what we wanted to do. So we were exchanging ideas and like getting each other's thoughts on it, and we started the design process. So because I had started on this some time ago, I had already done a design for a mounting mechanism for the rally tower. So we figured I'll do the mounting brackets. So that's essentially how the rally tower is going to fit onto the bike. And Devin was going to start designing and fabricating the rally tower itself. So the plan was eventually I'll have my brackets ready to mount the rally tower. He'll have his rally tower ready, and we'll meet one day and put both our components together. The next piece of development would be the windshield. Because it's a bit difficult to imagine what it would look like before having everything else on the bike, we figured we'll keep that for last so that we have a better picture of exactly what kind of dimensions we want to work with. So in this video, I'm going to talk about some of the considerations that I went through and why I decided to go certain ways in for certain design components. If you're designing your own rally tower, this will be very useful because these are questions that you'll be asking yourself as well. The first question that comes to mind when you design a rally tower is where you want to mount it. The first is that you could mount it straight onto the handlebar or the triple clamp and the forks. But then what happens is that every time you turn the handlebar, the entire tower moves around. So this means there's going to be a bit of additional weight that falls on the tower itself or on the handle, which isn't ideal. The second way is to mount the tower onto the bike's frame. So that means the tower itself wouldn't move when the handle is turned. The benefit here is that one, the handlebar doesn't have any additional weight on it. And two, because the tower can now extend a lot further because you're essentially extending the frame out, you could have a larger dashboard space. So you can have more accessories and things on your rally tower. So this is the approach I went with. It's a bit more difficult to design because you need to make sure that the brackets that extend from the frame don't collide with the forks or the triple clamp. And the wiring needs to kind of be neatly tucked away just to keep it from chafing around with other components. So I started off by taking everything apart, measuring the bike, the distances between bolts, how far things can extend, and drew up a couple of templates. So the templates came on first a soft cardboard, then a slightly harder cardboard. Then I used MDF board, and after I've got the MDF board sorted out, I decided to go with 3mm aluminium. Meanwhile, Devin was taking a more high-tech approach, drawing up his tower on his computer and coming up with a pretty intricate and neat design. So that tower looks awesome, and we'll talk about that in the future as well. So this project is quite a long one. So what I'm going to do is break it down into different components. In the next video, I'll be talking about how the brackets were designed and how I cut out the brackets. And there'll be another video where we talk about the tower and what design elements go into the tower itself. Then we'll talk about the electrical components that go onto the tower. And in another video, we will discuss how we design the windshield. So I'm sure there'll be a fair bit of interest in this project. And let me tell you, the design so far has been amazing. It looks really good. And Devin has done some mock-ups as well. And as we go on, I'll share more about the different components in these videos. So to see what happens and how things go and what you need to do to build your own rally tower, make sure to like this video and subscribe to On Two Wheels so that you get the latest update on this project. And stay tuned to see what happens next. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching On Two Wheels.